All right, guys, we are safe. It's all clear. I've checked everything. Shaka, guys, you've made it to the amazing Robosphere. This episode's Drawsome Awesome has high hopes and a tall order because I'm going to show you how to draw a giraffe. What? I heard something. Giraffes are the tallest mammals on earth, and they only sleep for between 10 minutes and 2 hours every day. Because they're always alert and they can see danger from really far, they make great lookouts. And in fact, all the animals, they just sort of hang around near them, all Hakuna Matata, because the giraffes are on the job. Funny? Yeah, but it's a fact. Quick question, why are giraffes' necks so long? Because their feet smell! I know it's a bad joke, but I have a good Drawsome Awesome for you. I promise, all you need is this. Shaka, guys, let's start drawing. With a pencil, I'm going to draw some basic shapes here. So first, for the body, we'll draw a big oval shape or a big bean shape. Something like this. Now, giraffes have long necks, so I'm drawing a long neck here with a straight line. For the head, I'll draw a big circle and next to it, a small circle. Now, for the legs, we'll draw some more oval shapes. Now, giraffes also have long legs. So we'll draw another oval shape and then we extend the leg further with a straight line. So you can see, we've got the basic form here. Now, let's add some detail to it. Starting from the neck, I'll add volume to the neck, connect it to the body, and then towards the tail, bring it down, just like that. Now let's shape the legs. So I'm extending the leg right from the body, so it looks connected, just going around the oval shape, just like that. With this curve, I'm highlighting the joint, and then extending the leg even further. The same thing we'll do for the other leg. Now from the body, I'll make a nice curve and move up to the neck. I'm going to draw a curve line like this over the first circular shape. And then going over the second circle, we'll make the mouth and continue that to the bottom, connecting it to the neck. Now giraffes have a really long sort of a face or head, so keep in mind when you're drawing. Now we add the horns, and with another oval shape, we add the ears. Okay, looks more or less ready. Now we can add the tail, and going down, we'll add the hooves. Okay, the basic drawing of the giraffe is ready. Now we're going to draw the pattern on it. Now different species of giraffes have unique patterns, but you can design your own giraffe fur. So let's start. You can draw squares, rhombus, or random patterns. So wherever there is bigger surface, the pattern becomes bigger. And where the surface is less, like the neck, legs, it becomes smaller. And there you go. Our giraffe is ready. Now let's quickly, with the marker, make our form permanent. Okay, the marker lines are done. Now I'm going to erase some of the pencil lines. Okay, I've erased all the pencil lines and now it's time to color. And with that, our giraffe is now ready. Let's frame the masterpiece. There you go. Isn't that terrific? Or should I say giraffe-erific? If you want to come hide out in the Robosphere, just come. It's safe, it's fun, and it's super creative. So subscribe, and that way we can find you too. I love it when you guys write back about all the art you create. Send it in here. or tell me what you want to learn to draw or create, and I'll show you. There's lots more where this came from. So for now, I'm saying Shaka, and you guys, Hakuna Matata. Hakuna Matata, which means no worries. So no worries, create art, let's get connected, stay updated, and stay in touch. Subscribe, watch, enjoy. Shaka.